All right, I know. I got my funny look here, this head bandage. I don't know. I have to cool it on my east block here. It's my accent is it's sometimes just too heavy, even for myself. So I'm trying to switch to American. Americano, tuba, baranda, like in the parade they go. Da da da, dun dun, yeah, isn't that it? Yeah. Da da da, da da na na, da 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 da, something like this, yeah. So yeah, I have to get back into American paradeism. Oh my gosh, I don't know. I don't watch TV, you know. So, because I don't watch TV. I just don't catch it. I don't catch your quickie tongue so fast back, you know. I mean, I've been places, you know what I'm saying? I've been very far away. Yeah, so it's difficult to just be like in Dallas. Oh, I can try really, really hard to be Dallasonian. Like, I never left. That would be a very funny one. I have to work on it, though. I have to work on it. I don't think it's going to happen anytime soon, that Dallasonian. They seem real, real, like, you know, Dallasonian is different. It's a Texas. They got the Texas. You know, Texas. I can't even do Texas right now. Forget it. Y'all, I can y'all you all you, but I can't really go Texas right now. Cry. I'm so sorry. I know I've been annoying because I know subliminally, and you know, in the back of your mind you're like, oh, Russian, ew, hater. Yeah, I don't know. Just want everybody to get over it, I guess. I'm kind of pushy that way. You know. It's sad. Did you hear what happened? Oh, I can try it. Ooh, ooh, ah, ooh, ah. It's kind of like that, isn't it? Ooh, ah, ooh, ah. Yeah. Like I have, like, oh, you know, I used to speak this way a little bit. Yeah. Yeah. When I had rabbits. I used to have rabbits. Yeah. Like as pets. And when I had rabbits as pets, I used to speak this way, like, really. So maybe that's it, you know. I just have to pretend I have rabbits again. Yeah. Funny. Yeah. Hmm. Da da. No. There was something much more important that I was saying. It was about. No, I'm stuck on the rabbits. They're fun. They're fun pets. Have you ever had them? They like. Oh yeah, and with this particular type of a voice, I'm just like, I don't know. Explainez-vous. I'll explainez-vous about rabbits. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, they don't actually need a cage. They don't need a cage at all. They can live even in your kitchen. And so you just like give them like a little tiny area in your kitchen, and you feed them lettuce, and you feed them, they love, you know what they really love? They love some kind of, gosh, what do they really love? Oh my gosh, they're so funny. They are so funny. Nibble, 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 nibble. Yeah. Now, they don't want fruits, they don't want vegetables. That much. No, I'm sorry. They want vegetables, but they don't want fruits. Except maybe apples. They'll take apples. Don't really give them oranges or anything like that. I don't think they're really into citrus. Oh, it's been years. I mean, I'm talking years since I had bunny rabbits. They're hysterical, though. And oddly, they're not that messy. They're not that messy. And they can be cat litter trained. You take like a little kitty cat box. And you don't use the cat litter that you see at the cat litter store. You put the you put toilet paper. I know this like extremely excessive, don't you, Charmin? But yeah, you use just like an unperfumed toilet paper, and you just shred it, and you put this unperfumed toilet paper in a kitty litter box, and in the kitty litter box, then you put the rabbit in, and you block them in, so they only have like this much space to bounce around in, and then there's the box. And so then they're like, what's the deal? Okay, so then they filth the box up, and very rarely that little tiny space. And then you just expand the space a little bit more and a little bit more and a little bit more. And then the bunny rabbit remembers, that's where I go in that special zone. And over here I don't. And for some reason it works. And I've trained two rabbits that way, so it's no big deal. But get them young if you're gonna go, you know, bunny raising, and they can be really fun, and they can thump their feet, their back feet, when they don't get their way, if you let them out, if you let them like out of the kitchen and you let them around the house, that's fun also. They can hop around all over the house. As long as they remember to go back to their tidy little spot. And if they go back to their tidy little spot, don't get angry. They might leave little tiny little droppings, but very few, very few. And they're small enough that it's not a bother. I mean, they're really, really little. And it's very rare. Once they've been trained, they don't actually do it as much as you think. They don't use the whole house. I've been pretty successful, and I even find, even outside, I've let them outside, but they will return right back and go back into their box and prefer their litter box. So they're kind of fun that way. Yeah. And as far as like the boss of the kitchen, they do become the boss of the kitchen, and they'll go up on your leg. They'll just go right up to your knee or whatever, and they'll just stay there, and they'll go, what do I get, you know. So they really are sweethearts, and they like to be packed around. So you carry your rabbits. They can watch TV with you if you're a TV watcher. All kinds of things that, you know, you can carry in places. And just like if you had like a little Yorkshire Terrier, same deal. Yeah. So yeah, just like that. And a basket, they like baskets. So what was the deal? I think you can give them nuts, but I don't remember us ever giving them nuts. It was really just vegetables and the pellets. They get those pellets that you get like at one of those pet stores. They get the special pellets. What else do they get? Oh my gosh. Oh, alfalfa. It has to be alfalfa. There's some deal with alfalfa. It has some ingredient extra. So yeah, they need alfalfa. Dun, 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 dun. And yeah, and just greens or the other greens. But if you give them too much lettuce and you don't have the alfalfa, they go runny. They get runny system. So you can't give them too many greens that way, and just expect, oh, I'll just feed them lettuce. It just doesn't work. You don't ever feed them dairy. You don't feed them milk products. They really don't adapt to that type of deal. So yeah, but they're kind of fun. They're kind of fun that way, and it just makes for a better like house when you're like in one room, and then all of a sudden you just see the bunny rabbit hop by and it, you know, just in the hallway, and you'll be like, what was that? You know, there's that moment of, what was that? You know, who goes there? You know, that's impossible, you know. And it just like takes you out of, you know, whatever, you know, whatever thought you were in before, and just like wakes you up to like, well, that was a rabbit in your house. just free, you know, free flow rabbit in the house. And they do. They go wherever they want to go. Sometimes they'll just go underneath the bed. They like to go underneath the bed, and they'll just lay down there and just take a snooze. And totally stretch out. They just stretch out like you can't believe. Sometimes they'll get right up on the sofa. And my rabbit was even so friendly with my big dogs that she would get like right on their back, like literally right on their back, and just stay there. And so whatever was like going on, like with the television, she would be on top of the big husky and just lay down there. And it was just like nothing to them. It was just no big deal. It was an older dog though. It was an older husky. Had to have been like, oh my gosh, maybe like seven years old, but yet totally accepted my rabbits, and no big deal. So yeah. So think about that. You know, if you have a real passive dog, they're gonna become friends, and way much like you can't believe. I did though. There, watch it though, because there is the one dog. We had one dog that was like a Malamute, and this Malamute was not used to rabbits, and went into the rabbit cage, and started slurping the rabbit. Not the cage, but you know the zone. You know, it was just the crisscross zones. You know the lattice. You use the lattice crisscross that goes like this, the lattice, and then crosses like that. It's like they use to cross doorways, and when you're crossing a doorway like that, and you know, so you don't go upstairs, those types of deals. That's all they need, and they'll stay in. And get the big fat ones. Get the big fat ones. Get the ones that have the floppy ears. I mean, I don't know. One of mine. She was in a suitcase, and she was playing in a suitcase. And it was all, you know, getting packed, you know, traveling, whatever. And she like goes right into the suitcase, and the suitcase goes grunk, 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 and just lands right on her leg, and she broke her leg. The suitcase just completely busted her leg. So when that went on, we had to take her to the doctor, or the veterinarian, and the veterinarian, he didn't do anything for her, really. He just wrapped her up in a bandage, and I'm like, well, we could have done that at home. I had no idea you were going to be that, you know, tremendous. So that was a bummer. But anyway, she took the flight. It was no big deal. So she could still travel with us. So that was interesting. That was interesting. She had to, I don't know, still take it, take the flight with us. So, yeah, but it was painful for her. I didn't want her to have to travel with a broken leg. I mean, that's you know, I don't know. So it took her like 3 to 6 months, and she was in that until she was really back to normal. But she wore that bandage for like 3 months, and then it was real tough. It was real tough for the next three, and I thought she was never going to get out of it, but she did. She did. She absolutely got back to all rabbit fours and started hopping normal and kicking. And they do that. They kick, and they can get angry. They can get, you know, grunty around, but they're excellent. They're excellent pets. I absolutely, you know. But you have to be around your animals. I mean, there's no way you cannot have a pet, and expect it to like give back to you if you're only home at your house for like 2 hours. I mean, you have to be there. I mean, that's the thing. People are like, I don't really, you know, I like my pet. I like my animal. But then when you all of a sudden, you know, aren't there. I mean, you can't expect a master and circus acts out of it. You have to do some serious, you know, home time with it. You know, that's just the way it goes. Hippity hoppity, hippity hoppity, hippity hoppity, you know, and that's the way it is. So you could be reading, you know, like you have to do your homework. And then hippity hoppity hippity hoppity, there they are, you know. It's just like excellent. Yeah. And if you have two at a time, it's even funner, because then they'll chase each other around the house and play games. So yeah. Oh, and they do actually they will roll balls. Like if you have like a little ball that has like some kind of a jingle in it can be any kind of like a cat toy jingle. that rolls. They love to roll them around. So don't ever, and even a tennis ball, but not as fun. They don't enjoy tennis balls as much. They prefer if it has like a, that little kind of a jingly sound in there. So yeah, and soft. They like soft things. So yeah, that's fun. So I guess so. I phew, needed a breakout of that for, I was really going into the thick. All right.